Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today we're going to be looking at the charging system on our 2005 Honda VTX 1800. Basically, it's made up of three different parts that we need to test. First, the battery, then we need to take a look at the stator, and then the regulator rectifier. So let me go grab a couple of tools, bring this up a little bit higher so it's easy to work on, and we'll get started. All right, guys, let me tell you the tools that we're going to need to get this done. You're going to need a 5 and a 6 millimeter Allen, a decent ratchet, and most importantly, you're going to need a good quality volt ohm meter. Specifically, what you're going to need is one that can do a diode test, so make sure it has that little symbol right there. All right, let's start by taking the seat off. It's a couple of 6 millimeter Allens that are hidden up under the seat, right above where the rear shock absorbers are. Next, we need to get that battery holder out of the way. It's just held in by three Phillips. There's two back here, and then one that's hidden up under the wiring harness. Definitely be careful with the wiring harness. And I usually leave it plugged into the ECU because those pins will wear out if you keep plugging and unplugging it. I don't know about you, but I don't want to replace a wiring harness. ECU flipped up, this just lifts out. All right, let's get a static reading on the battery. Should be really close to 13 volts, anywhere in between, I'd say 12.5 up to 13 is usually indicative of a good battery. Now I'm sure that I actually do have a good battery because we just replaced this one recently. So 12.65 sitting static. So that's about what I expected. All right, and to actually test the charging system, what we're looking for is a number greater than that 12.6 volts, but not exceeding 15.5. And you want to rev up the machine to roughly 4,000 RPMs when you're looking for this measurement. So we'll go ahead and fire up and see what we have. All right, that read about 14.6, and that's basically exactly where we want it to be. If it was over 15.5, that means that it was overcharging the battery and it would eventually cook it. If you did that and it just read the battery voltage, well, that means there was still a problem. And what we need to look at next is the stator and the voltage regulator rectifier. All right, let's get this cover out of the way right here. It's just held in by a bunch of 5 millimeter Allens. Next, just push back that rear cover. Plug we're actually after is right here. It's a three-wire conductor. It's got all yellow wires. So that's what's heading down to the stator. Right there. All right, to test our stator, what we're going to do is set our meter to ohms. And what we're looking for here from leg to leg is a reading somewhere in between 0.1 and 1 ohms. So what you want to do is go in between each one. All right, 0.5, that's what we're looking for. And go here, 0.5, and then in between these two, 0.4, 0.5, so somewhere in there. All right, what that is telling us is that the three legs or the three windings in there are reading about what they should. The other thing you want to check for is to make sure that nobody's shorted to ground. So go to your negative terminal on your battery with one end, and then we'll just go to each leg. So that's open, open, open. All right. We pretty much knew that the stator was in good operating order, and it is, and it measured as it should. Now, if there was a problem, what would you see? Well, you would either see probably an opener or a direct short when you went from each one of these legs when you were measuring to each one. That would signify that they've probably heated up and they're actually making a direct contact. Hence, it wouldn't be charging on all three outputs. The other is that one of the legs might have shorted out to ground. And that's why we did the measurement from here to here. And if that read anything other than an open circuit, then there would be a problem with the stator. But we knew this one was good, but I just wanted to show you what to look for. Next, we're going to look at the regulator rectifier. All right, what does that actually do? All right, its job is to take the AC voltage, which comes out of your stator, and converts it into DC, which the motorcycle needs to charge the battery. Now, how does it actually do that? Well, hidden inside this heat sink are all the electronic circuits. What we're actually going to check is just the diodes that are inside of here. Well, now, what does a diode do? Well, that lets current only flow in one direction. So in essence, it's only going to let it flow to the positive side of the AC side. So once it gets that, then it starts to level it off with the capacitors, which gives you your DC charge voltage. So we're just going to check the diodes. Well, how are we going to do that? We're going to set up our meter to where it is set to diode, and we're going to actually forward bias them. And when we do that, we should read about 0.5 volts. Take your positive lead and put it on the negative of the battery. And then what we're going to do is go to each one of these, after I've unplugged it coming from the stator, each one of those wires, yep, and it should read around 0.5 volts. That's what you're looking for each one. It's 0.93, 0.95, 0.92. So that's telling me that the diodes are good inside of the one on the motorcycle. All right, now that we know that our diodes are in good shape, the only other thing you want to check is basically the wiring from this connector right here. What we're going to be looking for is battery voltage as well as the ground. All right, your battery voltage needs to be on both of these red wires, and then we need to show ground on both of these green. So let's check voltage first. All right, go into our negative. So there's our battery voltage. On both of the reds, then we flip over to ohms. Should be is very close to 0.1, 0.2 ohms, 0.3 is close enough. 0.3. So all that wiring checks out. All right, guys, that pretty much wraps it up. The only thing I have left to do is just get this cover back on and the seat remounted. Other than that, she's ready to go. Well, listen, if you need any of the parts that you found to be bad, come find us on Partzilla.com and we can get you taken care of. Have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Until next time, we just want to say thanks for watching.